Hello, and thanks for checking out ChartGuys.com. We're proud to be one of the most successful technical analysis communities online, teaching you the skills to become a more confident, effective, and informed trader. Join our community of hundreds of analysts worldwide working together to learn the charts, generate profit, and achieve financial independence. For access to daily live chart analysis and market coverage, a thriving chat community, along with dozens of hours of exclusive educational materials. We look forward to seeing you. Let's check out some charts. Everyone checking in on the markets. So we had the initial bearish reaction to the Netflix earnings with the gap down in the tech sector and the markets as well. And of course, the bulls furiously bought hand over fist for the entirety of the day, essentially. And when you see SPY like this, I use, as a day trader, I use the 4 and the 8 period exponential moving average. And when you see the price action like this, this always says to me either institutions or algos or bots, some combination of that is going on. And the fact that we didn't see any consolidation. I mean, look at the start of the day where we had 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21 candlesticks on the 5-minute time frame, and 19 of them were green. So holding these exponential moving averages for hours in a row, that's when it shows up. We've seen this on individual names like CMG and other names like that, but haven't seen it in SPY in a while, but Netflix was doing the same thing. We look at Netflix on the 5-minute. Clear signal there was breaking 360, the high of pre-market, and bulls were off to the races as soon as that happened and followed through with significant buying of the dip. So SPY bulls heading to higher highs. Next resistance. Again, resistance is limited. The all-time high with the dividend factored in is 284.21. Without it, it's in the 286s, and the bulls are in absolute full control. We can consolidate on this weekly time frame, and anything above 268.49 will keep the bulls in full control. So I've certainly had that sentiment the past couple videos, and that's not changing anytime soon. So geopolitical situations are not causing any kind of pullback. Bearish reaction to the financial sector earnings isn't doing it. Oil dumping for 5 days isn't doing it. Netflix bearish earnings are not doing it. So the bottom line is, I don't know what it's going to take to knock these bulls off the path that they're on, but nothing in sight at this point. IWM grinding against the middle Bollinger Band, looking to establish a higher low. Currently 165.96. Bulls would like to shift momentum back in their favor after this few days of consolidation. 168.73 would have us look back at the all-time high of 169.87. Weekly time frame, healthy consolidation, looking to maintain higher lows. Anything above 161.89 will do it. QQQ in the tech sector, there's that huge gap down, but huge buying of the dip with a bullish engulfing candlestick. New all-time high here as well, 180.65, just psychological resistance levels. Weekly chart is all bull. Anything above 169.17 is the higher low on the weekly chart. And we look at VIX. VIX is still weak. Surprising we didn't break 11.62, but not a whole lot for the bulls to hope for at this point. Potentially a new daily lower high of 13.18 if we do drop down and break 11.62 and head down to 11.22. So the weekly time frame, still weak. All moving averages back as resistance. Couple support levels bulls are barely clinging to at this point, and we'll see if those do end up breaking in the coming weeks if the market bulls are headed back to all-time highs in the S&P 500. So that's where we stand, short and simple. XLF, we're watching the financial sector and the daily time frame, trying to keep those higher lows. Anything above 2670 will maintain higher lows, stalling out a little bit, but on the weekly time frame, it's all about the middle Bollinger Band, which we've been rejecting from time and time again, almost, you know, 8 times at this point. And we have to see a break of 2815 to break the lower highs. Break the lower highs on the weekly time frame for the financial sector, and pretty much all-time highs for the S&P 500 will be a sure thing. So any consolidation will be healthy on SPY. We know we're getting a little extended, but we've seen that before. 4-hour RSI climbing towards 70. The hourly RSI cooled off a bit with a little bull flag at the end of the day, but that's a little extended as well. Any consolidation, we're just going to look for it to be healthy and to keep the bulls in control. Only declining, I should say, increasing bear volume and a loss of key daily supports are going to have me change my bullish tune. Appreciate you watching. We'll see you tomorrow.